The nutrition situation in Nigeria, South Sudan, Somalia and Yemen is extremely worrying. But the figures of 20 million people and $4.4 billion do not suffice to declare a famine. The definition of a famine is very precise, and MSF's experience in the area should help provide some context. There are five levels of food insecurity, with famine being the worst. The term famine can be used when the following criteria are met. The mortality rate exceeds 2 deaths per 10,000 people per day. Acute malnutrition exceeds 30%. And one person in every 5 is not getting enough to eat. According to surveys held in these 4 countries this winter, only 2 counties in South Sudan fulfill these criteria. The others are considered at risk. MSF knows from experience that periods of actual famine are relatively rare. They are limited both in time and space and are marked by very high mortality, not just among those considered at risk, young children and the elderly, but the whole population. The causes of famine are varied. They can be natural. But in the case of these 4 countries, the food insecurity is largely man-made, with conflicts preventing people from cultivating their land, cutting off supply routes, and pushing up food prices. There are 3 ways to respond to a food crisis. Re-establish access to adequate supplies of nutritious food. This can be achieved either by enabling local people to cultivate their fields, to tend to their livestock and trade, or by distributing food. These require allowing civilians and aid workers to circulate freely. Provide nutritional support to the most vulnerable, particularly children. Timely distributions of food supplements adapted to their specific needs prevent the onset of acute malnutrition. Treat cases of severe acute malnutrition, either in the home with ready-to-use therapeutic foods or in hospital. Medical teams also treat malaria, respiratory infections and diarrhea, illnesses triggered by malnutrition and that increase the likelihood of death. None of these are possible in some areas of Nigeria, South Sudan, Yemen and Somalia, not through lack of funds, but because their inhabitants are isolated and cut off from the world by warring parties who have little concern for their survival, but on whom access to aid depends.